Welcome back. It has been a challenging year for the class of 2020, a generation that grew up with everything available online, now has to finish their senior year online.
And we have been talking with four high school seniors, and now we want to talk with Michelle Morris Carter, principal at Milwaukee's Golda Meir School.
Ms. Morris Carter, what have you been telling your students and advising them through all of this? Because this is not easy for a lot of students and parents, really.
Right. I think our number one goal is to try to create just continued sense of normalcy in terms of expectations around what seniors are typically doing during this time. And one of those things is like applying for scholarships. Our students have been very grateful for the time away to be able to complete a lot of those scholarship opportunities that oftentimes go by the wayside because they're typically so busy with work outside of school and completing classwork that they don't have that devoted time to always give to applying for these scholarship options. And so we are just continuing to message to them the importance of getting those things done. We're also reiterating to them the importance of just ending their year very positively and strong, and that's important as it relates to their grades. Colleges review final transcripts. So as much work that can still be completed, we're encouraging them to get that done and to still take their education seriously. And so because many of our kids have been used to utilizing virtual platforms through Google Classroom as such, they're familiar with how to stay in contact with their teachers, uploading those assignments, staying on track so that they can finish their high school career with the best grades possible.
Yeah, they got to get across the finish line here strong. You've also instituted a program here to help pair up students with mentors here?
Yes. So our guidance counselor started a program that not only benefits students at Golda Meir School, but all MPS students and students throughout the Milwaukee area. It's called the Adoptive Student Program. And what it does is pair seniors with mentors in the community. This has been such an exciting experience for so many of our students because they've connected with people in their career fields. One student in particular shared with me that her mentor paid for her professional membership into a business organization that she's going to be looking to participate in when going into college. So these mentorships have become increasingly important. They've served to help support our students with summer internship opportunities and just small mementos of, we've got your back, we're here to support you, we're very proud of you, continuously come through from these mentors. So it's been an amazing way for our students to partner with members of the community that will hopefully create lasting connections for a lifetime, but especially through those college years, which are oftentimes so crucial for our kids. So for many, this has been an awesome opportunity to make those connections.
Yeah, that Adopt a Senior program is so perfect, and I know it's really popular on Facebook, so, and we're going to be featuring this a little bit later on Positively Milwaukee, so I have to let you know about that. And you know, Ms. Carter, when you look at some of the students that are out there having to deal with learning virtually, are there any kind of secrets that you feel that you've been able to find from the kids and learn as an adult? Because a lot of people say, I'm using technology like I've never learned before in this day and age.
Yeah, I think the learning curve is definitely much more challenging for the adults than it is for the kids. And they've actually been very instrumental in helping us navigate our way through the process. So I just think like teachers being very vulnerable about their strengths as it relates to technology and their weaknesses has definitely helped in the communication of learning goals and expectations around assignment completion for our kids. Because we recognize that we don't know everything. And just really establishing more of like a partnership in this work, looking to students to create those kinds of ideas, give us more insight into how we can make things better. Like guidance counselors are really working to provide those social emotional learning supports for our kids. They're connecting through Zoom, having meetings where kids can just come and share like socially and emotionally what they're going through. So that's been really helpful to not only our students, but I think a tremendous number of students in our district.
Michelle, that is all good information. We thank you very much for joining us. And as we head to break, I'm going to try to show you my high school senior picture there. As we, when we come back, we'll talk about the jobs market.